Hey, tootRN fam. Here's a question that one of my students and I were working on together yesterday. And this question is not a super difficult question by any means as far as cognitive level is concerned. However, this is a question that sometimes will get students and will get test takers in the sense of you feel like, shoot, like this is something I have to know or I'm not gonna be able to answer it, right? And those questions can feel overwhelming because you feel like it's just a knowledge thing. It's just a content thing. And if I don't know what the heck this is, I can't answer this question. But what's really important is that you will develop good, strong, intuitive question detective skills. And that's what I want to show you today. I want to show you that with this type of question. When you feel like, you know what? I have no clue what this is. I have no clue what I'm doing here. There's ways that you can best help yourself to work through the question. So let's look at this one together. It says, a client with cancer has a calcium level of 11.8 milligrams per deciliter. Which symptom would indicate a need for the nurse to call the physician for treatment orders? So option A says increased gastric motility. Option B says peaked T waves on 12-lead ECG. Option C says muscle spasms. And option D says muscle weakness. So let's pretend like we're looking at this question and you're thinking calcium level of 11.8, I don't know. I don't even know what that level's supposed to be. I don't know if that's high, low, have no idea. All these signs, don't know what it is. It happens, right? It happens to all of us. We're always gonna come across the question, guaranteed, that you feel like, I have no idea what this is. But we have to adopt a best practice to try to help you to make sure that you are eliminating options in a smart way. So straightforward, this question is just asking us, which symptom would indicate a need for the nurse to call the physician for treatment order? So which one of these things, if it happens, I gotta call the physician. And it's telling us that this client has cancer and they have a calcium level of 11.8. So yes, this is up to us to know, is that normal or not normal? Meaning, is it okay or is it too high or too low? And which one of these things, as the question is asking us, do we need to call the physician about? So again, let's work from a point of, I don't know if that's normal or not. How do I figure out the answer? So we're gonna use our detective skills. We're gonna use our intuition to look at each answer option. Now, if I look at A, it has increased gastric motility. So it's hyperactive, right? This indicates an increase of something. If I look at B, it says peaked T waves on a 12-lead ECG. So I'm having like these tall spiked T waves. So again, this kind of shows an increase of something, right? C says muscle spasms. So again, this is something that's like an increased activity, hyperactivity, an increase of something. That's what spasms are. And D says muscle weakness, which is actually something then that would be low. This reflects a lack of activity. So when I look at all of these answer options, that's something that I can find in common, considering we're coming from a point that we feel like we have no idea what any of this stuff is, right? So A, B, and C, they all have something in common. This is all an increase, hyperactivity, a lot of activity, something is heightened. They all share that. But D is the only thing that's completely different than all of that. So, and just sheer best practice guessing alone, using our critical thinking skills and intuition, I would choose D, muscle weakness. And muscle weakness is a sign of hypercalcemia. 11.8 is a high calcium value. So on one hand, if you knew that value right off the bat and you knew clearly that hypercalcemia and muscle weakness go together, you would jump on that answer. But if you didn't, there's still a way to use intuition, to use critical thinking, to use your analyzing skills to really sift through each answer option and eliminate in the best way possible.